Hey everyone, my name is Daniel and welcome back to another video. I hope all of you are having a great day out there. As always, here today, I want to talk to you about what is, in my opinion, one of the best cryptocurrencies out there. Let me preface this by saying one of the best types of cryptocurrencies out there, and I'll go through a couple of examples of cryptos that actually fall under the category of this type of crypto, and it's really a style of cryptocurrency investing that I think really has yet to catch on and is really underappreciated. And in this video, I'm going to talk to you all about exactly what this is, exactly how it compares to normal cryptocurrency investing in the sense of, you know, investing in Bitcoin, Ethereum, Cardano, etc. And I'll go through some examples as well as to what these cryptos are and whether or not I'm invested in them. So if you end up enjoying this video and potentially even end up finding some value in it, please consider subscribing. And with that out of the way here, let's get into this video. So first and foremost, let's talk about so-called regular cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, Ethereum, or pretty much every crypto out there is based off of one sole principle, the principle of supply and demand. You have so many Bitcoins out there and you have so many people that want to buy it. As, you know, supply stays stagnant, as you have a deflationary asset, and as demand increases or decreases, you should see price fluctuation. The bet that you're making with a majority of these cryptos is that, A, over the long run, these cryptos are going to stay in the sense, or kind of the amount of these cryptos are going to stay stagnant in the sense of, you know, the amount of Bitcoins or Ethereums or Cardanos out there, while demand for these cryptocurrencies will increase, and thus with that, you should see price appreciation. Now, you also have, B, the fact that people are investing in these cryptos for staking, being able to earn 3, 5, even 12% interest on a yearly basis through something like Polkadot by, you know, simply staking your tokens and, you know, in doing so, operating the network through the staking system, which I'm not going to go through, but it's another kind of way of, let's say, proof of work, which is something like Bitcoin mining, which operates the network. Either way, I'm not going to go down that rabbit hole in this video, but that is what I consider the generic type of cryptocurrency, the one where you're betting on this crypto to continue to gain adoption, continue innovating, and continuing to, again, expand the ways they're able to kind of fit in real world scenarios through smart contracts or through higher transaction speeds, things like that. But there's another side of cryptocurrencies, and it's something that focuses around the idea of utility. This is something that not only has the same principle as what we just talked about with, again, supply staying relatively stagnant as demand increases, you should see price appreciation. You also have staking rewards for these cryptocurrencies. But in addition to that, you're able to use the cryptocurrencies that you hold, and we'll go through some examples in a moment, and actually gain certain rewards. Now, the thing about a lot of these cryptocurrencies is that they're very tied to a certain platform or a certain company. And by owning these cryptos, again, not only are you making an investment, not only are you getting staking rewards, but you're able to get bonus utility on these platforms and get certain features or products that people who don't hold these cryptocurrencies aren't able to access. Now, let me kind of explain this a little bit further here by going through a couple of examples. These are both cryptocurrencies that I do own and that I do believe in for the long run. They make up a majority of my cryptocurrency portfolio and are my two biggest positions. And I hope, you know, this video kind of explains my thought process behind exactly, you know, why they have such a large allocation. But either way, first and foremost, let's go through StormX, ticker symbol STMX. This is a crypto that I did talk about roughly mid-June-ish. It's one that does make up, you know, a rather significant part of my crypto portfolio. I think it's actually the second biggest holding behind the second one, which we'll talk about in a moment here. But when you look at StormX, this is a market cap of just around $300 million, trading at just around 3 cents per token. Now, I originally talked about this on roughly June 16th was the exact date. It was trading just around 2 cents at that time. Obviously, volatility came into play in a major way as we saw cryptocurrencies fall in the month of July, but it's been on a massive roller coaster, now trading at around 3 cents. But either way, let's take away the price action and analyze what this company is and how it kind of fits into the idea of utility and why utility is such a big thing to focus on with cryptocurrencies as a whole. First and foremost, when you look at StormX, this is a company that focuses on cashback. When you shop at Nike or eBay or let's say, you know, something like AliExpress or Wish, If you do that through the StormX platform, you get a certain percentage cash back, whether that be 3%, 5%, 7%, you're able to get money back by simply shopping at these stores online. Now, the way StormX does this, they partner up with these companies, say, hey, all right, you give us a bit of a discount, and in a, you know, kind of in return to that, we're gonna give you actual customer traffic. And you know, different companies give different rewards. Something like Nike here may give 5%, while eBay may only give 1.6%, entirely dependent on the actual, you know, company that they partner with. But either way, how does the StormX token tie into this and tie into this platform, which will continue to innovate moving forward and again become much more than just a crypto cash back company and potentially expand into freelancing and other ideas, which we're not going to talk about in this video because, you know, I do have a separate StormX video on that, which I will leave rather in the description down below. But either way, you look at StormX here. How do they tie in STMX and how does it bring utility? Well, it's through their membership or so-called loyalty program. The more StormX you own, the more cash back you get at these different stores. Let me give an example here. Let's say a store like eBay or a platform gives 5% cash back, or you know, StormX gives 5% cash back on all eBay products, which is, you know, that's, you know, significantly overestimating the percentage they give, but let's just use 5% for, you know, number's sake. In this case, if you have 3,000 StormX tokens, which, hey, it's trading just around, what, 3 cents at this point, so not a significant amount of money, you get 1.25x more cashback rewards. So in this situation, you'd get an extra 1.25%. So roughly 6.25% by simply shopping at, or 6.2%, roughly thereabouts, by simply shopping at eBay. And this kind of grows as you expand the silver tier, the gold tier, and the, you know, platinum and whatnot. The more StormX you hold, the more cash back that you get and the more utility that brings. So by owning the StormX token, not only are you placing a bet on this project and the, you know, future adoption of it, but, you know, obviously as users grow at StormX, hopefully, you know, demand will increase, supply stays rather stagnant. You see that, again, appreciation in price, but you also get this major utility through the sense of, hey, I'm holding my StormX tokens, I'm making an investment, but in addition to that, I'm able to get additional rewards and utilize these tokens in a major way through another aspect of my life, which in this case is e-commerce. That is something that I really like, and I think StormX really portrays this idea in a very great way. Now, you know, this is just one example. They also do offer staking of the StormX tokens, which is, again, roughly 10% per year. This will, you know, get significantly lower with time, rather, but you kind of have everything that those other cryptocurrencies have in the sense of price appreciation over time and staking, but you also have utility, which I really, really, really like, rather. Now, the next example that I want to go through here with all of you, and then we'll kind of wrap all of this up and give you all my kind of, you know, overall thoughts on the style of investing, is the VGX token. This is a company, Voyager. I talk about this a lot on the channel here. Voyager stock specifically is my biggest investment in my overall portfolio. But, you know, when you look at Voyager, they're essentially a cryptocurrency brokerage. They offer over 60 cryptocurrencies on their platform. You can earn interest on over half of those. And, you know, those interest rates are actually best in class, significantly better than BlockFi, very similar to Celsius. But you look at the VGX token here. It's very, very similar in the sense that it's tied to the Voyager platform in a major way. Supply will stay relatively stagnant over the coming years. And in addition to that, you have staking rewards and are able to earn interest on a yearly basis by simply holding the VGX token. Now, again, price action of this guy has been all over the place. I started buying at around the $2 range, roughly the same time as I started buying StormX, roughly mid-June, early July. I actually bought significantly more here today at this roughly $2.50 level. But again, let's kind of take away the price action here. Let's focus on the fundamentals and how the VGX brings utility. First and foremost, we just talked about the business. You understand it. If you live in the United States, which, you know, I don't have, you know, I don't live in the US, at least at this moment in time, so I'm not able to actually download the Voyager app. But if you are, feel free to download it, check it out. When you look at the VGX token, it ties with the Voyager platform in a significant way. And again, when you look at both of these so-called loyalty programs, they will develop and evolve with time and bring more utility over time. But It's tied to the platform in a significant way. By holding the VGX token, and it's actually tiered off here in the same way you have with StormX to 500 tokens, 5,000 tokens, 20,000 tokens, you get, you know, the same amount of staking, no matter how much you hold, but you get different rewards beyond that. First and foremost, earnings reward boosters. So this is essentially on Bitcoin, Ethereum, USDC, the percentage you get on a yearly basis, whether it be like, let's say 6% for something like Bitcoin, if you own the Adventurer tier, you get something like 6.5%. If you hold the Explorer tier, you get 7%. If you hold the Navigator tier, you get 7.5%. Hopefully that makes a bit of sense. And again, this is for Ethereum, Bitcoin, and USDC, at least at this point in time. From my understanding, we'll see what happens with that over time. You have refer a friend, boosters, get more money by referring a friend, and crypto cash back. So whenever you actually make a trade on the platform, you actually get a certain amount of money back. And again, this ranges, but there has been a lot of kind of activity on this on Twitter, and people are really enjoying getting crypto payments on a bi-monthly basis, from my understanding, by simply holding VGX tokens and trading within the Voyager platform. So this is another example of a token that is tied with the growth and success of this company, of this so-called project. It's a token that gives staking rewards, and in addition to that, brings utility through the different things that they offer. So when you look at these two tokens, they have a lot in common. And this whole idea of utility, at least in my opinion, has a lot of potential over the coming years to really stand out from a lot of the other cryptocurrencies out there. Now, in my opinion, there's no doubt that, you know, Bitcoin, Ethereum, and the Voyager and StormX tokens can coexist. They are definitely totally different things. But when I look at these cryptocurrencies, I totally feel great of, you know, placing a bet on these projects that I totally believe in and support, but also being able to get rewards over the long run that benefit me beyond just price appreciation, and to a sense where I can actually use these tokens to improve my, you know, access and, you know, rewards that I get on these different platforms. This is the idea that I think it really stands out. It has a lot of potential over the coming years. And again, StormX, Voyager token, these aren't the only ones. You have Crypto.com doing something very similar. Binance with a BNB token doing something very similar. You have the Celsius. From my understanding, you also have a token that does something very similar. So you look at these different cryptocurrencies, the style of investing, I really like it. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comment section down below. In no way, shape, or form am I bagging on Bitcoin, Ethereum, Cardano. But I just think this whole kind of sector of utility tokens have a lot of potential over the coming years. And, you know, because of the fact that they're actually based on utility and based on people holding them for the long run and being incentivized to continue holding them no matter what the price action is, these may actually hold up much better than a lot of the other cryptos out there during something like a bear market, because of the fact that you're able to continue gaining high levels of utility no matter where the price action is. So that's my two cents on all of this. Let me know your thoughts are in the comment section down below. I think, you know, this kind of side of cryptocurrencies have a lot of potential over the coming years. And again, VGX token and StormX token, my first and second biggest positions in my crypto portfolio. We'll see what happens over the long run. I'm really excited. Anyways, thanks so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye-bye.